Sup everybody? You doing good out there? I hope so. Let me know in the comments below how your week's been. Can you guys see me good right now? I'm doing a new setup right quick. But anyway, if you gotta turn on the camera, vlog, because it's that time of week again. And, well, I know I'm a week late with this, and I don't really have been uploading much this week, but I'll get to that part in a second. Now, I know I'm late with this, but I want to talk about the Undertaker's retirement right quick. Okay, now the Undertaker, I considered him to be one of the greatest, if not the greatest, wrestler of all time. Okay, I know when I cosplayed as him in a few of my videos, there is a potential that some people may consider that as disrespect, but I loved The Undertaker until I rest in peace, no pun intended. But when he had that match against Roman Reigns, first of all, I didn't consider it a bad match, okay? But I don't think you can say the words Undertaker and bad match in the same sentence, okay? That's how much I like with The Undertaker, okay? And anyway, I was watching the match and at first I was skeptical about it, and then I had to like think about how I felt about it personally, because Undertaker, I considered him one of the greatest wrestlers of all time, and Roman Reigns, he's in my top five favorite wrestlers of today's generation, okay? I can't say that I have a current wrestler out of today's crop of superstars, but as far as greatest of all time, definitely Undertaker, but as far as greatest of today, Roman Reigns is definitely in the top five, but I can't honestly say who the best wrestler is right now. Okay. Sorry, my nostrils are itchy right now. Anyway, I was watching the match, and I thought it was decent, for the most part. Now, leading up to this, I heard speculation that this may have been Undertaker's last match, but I wasn't too sure. Because me, personally, I wanted to see for myself to see if it was true or not, okay? I even hit up my friend Zombie13, asking him, I said, Zombie, you think Sunday will be Undertaker's last match? And even he said it should be. Okay. So I watched the match, and when I saw the three come down for Roman Reigns, I honestly wasn't surprised, but when I saw Undertaker set back up, and he took his gloves off, he took his coat off, he took his hat off, he kissed Michelle McCool, and then he did that above the ring, or on the ramp, and lowered that to the ground. A lot of people speculated that he really did indeed retire, okay? Now, I said this on multiple occasions, that if Undertaker would have retired, I would have liked him to make it known that his last match would have been really his last match, okay? Win or lose. And with the way that Undertaker did that, with the way he retired, at first I wanted to cry, but instead I reflected. I reflected on the amazing career that Undertaker had already, okay? I honestly don't think that there's anything that Undertaker could have done in today's society, that in today's wrestling era, that would change who he is or make himself any better than he already is, okay? He's the freaking Undertaker, okay? His career started in November 1990, and it might have ended in April 2017, okay? So he's practically been a wrestler for almost 27 years now. It would have been 27 this November, okay? So, but, anyway, when Brock ended Undertaker's streak, he laughed about it, then he walked off. Okay. Roman Reigns, he I could tell even during the match, he was a little bit unsure about himself, okay? And when he won the match, he wasn't celebrating, okay? He even said to himself that it feels like a loss to him, okay? But as he was heading back up the ramp, he was looking over at the ring at Taker, just staring, okay? Meanwhile, some stupid idiot that belongs on Jericho's list decides to shoot fireworks off in the background, okay? And fireworks are about a celebration, and I really don't see what there was to celebrate about that moment, okay? Unless we were celebrating Undertaker's career as a whole, okay? And honestly, what I would have liked to see from Undertaker was that, like I said earlier, I wanted it to be known that Taker's last match would have been his last match before and after. Yeah, with the kind of person that Undertaker is, I guess even in retirement, he needs to remain mysterious if we're going to keep it kayfabe here. But if that really was Undertaker's last match, I'm accepting it. But I know one thing, though. Retirement or no retirement, sometime next month, or I don't know when I'm going to start doing it, but I'm just going to start binge-watching Undertaker matches. From back when he was at the Master of Pain in Tennessee, when he was Mean Mark Callis in WCW, and to when he debuted at Survivor Series, all the way up till when Roman Reigns, beat him. Okay. I've got two Undertaker DVD sets in there. There's a, well, three actually. I have an old 1996 DVD. Well, I can tell it used to be a tape, but somebody converted it into a DVD. But it's Undertaker Buried Alive. It was hosted by Ted DiBiase. Then there's Tombstone, the Undertaker collection, which came out in, the, I think, 2004. And then there's Undertaker's Greatest Matches. Those are my three Undertaker DVD sets. Okay. But I guess I'll do talk about the Undertaker for now. But when he did, hold on a second, when he did take his stuff off, his coat and everything, I would have minded if he would have done that thing one more time. You know, where he goes down to one knee. But anyway, I'm through talking about The Undertaker now. I hope to see him again in the future, okay? In retirement or not, I hope to see him in the future again soon, okay? Just so I can hear from him again, okay? Just not wanting to remain all mysterious and junk. Okay. Now, on another note, I know I said I haven't been uploading as much this week, okay? And there's a reason for that. Next Sunday is Easter Sunday, okay? And that is the deadline that I hope to have my roast movie finished, okay? And I'm still waiting for the channel that's collaborating with me to hit me up with their scene, okay? And I know that particular channel, or channels, however we want to look at it, is watching this video, probably. Okay. And guys, if you are out there watching, listen to me. I hope I'm not coming off as impatient or whatever, but I am really eager to work with you on this, okay? I couldn't find anybody else to collab with, and I just want to say thank you for helping me when I couldn't find anybody else. Okay? Really means a lot to me. Okay. But anyway, back to what I was saying, okay? I want to get the video finished this week, okay, as far as editing goes. Which means that sometime next week, I'm going to be doing the trailer for it. Okay? And a week after that, I think, or a week before the actual May 11th date comes, I'm going to be doing a promotional video for my reaction channel where I'm reacting to Everybody Loves Draven, okay? Which was a decent series, but I only reacted to the second episode, though. Yeah. I wish he'll do more of them. Those were pretty well done. I forgot the name of the guy who made it. But anyway, guys, and also with that, me taking the time off, earlier today I asked, Brandon and Wolf on Facebook for a favor, okay? Now, as far as if they were going to take this favor under consideration or not, it's beyond me, okay? Now, about me doing this whole, trying to get this movie finished, I'm having to take time off of doing uploads for SSP, my reaction channel, and my James Self-Centered account, okay? I mean, these vlogs ain't going nowhere, okay? I just need to, like, trying to focus on getting this movie finished, get it promoted, and I need to get as many eyes as possible on this movie, okay? And, dang, why the heck is my nostril so itchy? Well, but I want to get as many eyes as possible on this movie as I can, okay? And I hope, I don't think worried is the right word for it, but I'm kind of, cautious about how this video is going to turn out. Because I know I had a lot of, hate and trolls on this account now. I'm sorry. We got to say it for what it is, guys. This channel is troll-infested, okay? This channel is secretly troll-infested. And if you don't believe me, look at all the freaking dislikes I'm getting. Part of me wants to think it's just trolls being trolls and just trying to take time out of their day to hate me, but on the other side, though, it could just be that I suck, and I hope not, okay? I really hope I really don't suck that much. I mean, I guess what you call SSP is, SSP grows in time. It gets better in time, okay? Like me, I'm going to be turning 23 next month, okay? And I started this whole YouTube stuff when I was, I think, 20? Yeah, I think I was like 20 or 21 when I started SSP. But anyway, I am very cautious about how this movie's going to turn out. And I have a feeling that this, you know, I'm not going to jinx it. I'm going to, like, wait to make a prediction video about how it's going to turn out the week of. Okay? But yeah, guys, oh, by the way, about the whole Roman Reigns situation, let me go back to it for a second. I see it about Roman Reigns being the one that Undertaker passed the torch to. I guess I kind of see a lot of similarities between me and Roman Reigns because Roman is getting a lot of hate, just like I'm getting a lot of dislikes, okay? And we are both getting hated because we're doing the one thing that we love to do, okay? And you get maybe a troll out there, but you can't deny this fact, okay? If I love doing this, what you think out there is irrelevant, okay? This is my channel. I can upload whatever I want, whenever I want, as long as it's within the YouTube boundaries, not within your boundaries. I'm not here to please you. Okay, I'm not here to please you, Mr. Trolls. So, when you press your dislike button and not tell me why, you're wasting your time, Chico. Did I come off as too cocky when I said that? I hope not. Look, Trolls, I love you anyway, okay? Honestly, Trolls, I love you because you're the first ones to give any of my videos any kind of activity, okay? Yeah. But yeah, I don't know if I'm sorry, guys. You gotta forgive me. It's like late night right now. And I'm just turning on the camera and I'm riffing. But, yeah, like I told Brandon Wolf earlier on Facebook, with this whole me trying to get this movie project finished, my favorite for them was I do not want them to riff any of my SSP videos until my birthday, okay? Because my birthday, they're already going to be, doing an entire episode dedicated to me, alright? And if I'm not going to be doing much, save the ammo, okay? Maybe that's not the right term. Okay, save my videos for the birthday, okay? I mean, I'm not going anywhere, honestly. So yeah, guys, Brandon Law Wolf, try to just show mercy on me just up until my birthday, okay? And then you can put me on any of your podcasts that you want to, okay? I mean, heck, I'm not going to be like Von Helton asking you guys to pay me. Heck, the videos itself is paying me, okay? You featuring my videos is paying me, okay? I don't know about the rest of those people that you feature on your channel, but when it comes down to me, I think I'm the only one not being a jerk about it, okay? He who shall not be named, got butthurt about it. Von Helton, we all know about Von Helton. He's really not one of the nicest of people. Brett Keane, well, I can make macaroni and cheese better than he can. I'm going to be nice about that. But, so yeah, guys, just do me that one favor, please, okay? Do me that one favor, okay? I'll appreciate it. But yeah, guys, I'm going to go ahead and get out of here now. I got to go and get out of here now. Wish me luck in finishing this movie. To that channel that I'm collaborating with, please hurry up, please. Alright, I'm out now. Booyah. I love you guys. And yes, here comes the hug.